Yep, gotta get that fixed.
Explain why my tablet power was dropping too. Or my laptop.
All right, that's it for that part.
Well, if you guys want to check out the stream and say anything, go right ahead. Seems like I got a couple of people watching, new followers. Better out of it. So one thing I was talking about earlier in the stream with this particular model, I said there were a bunch of areas that you're never going to see. These are just going to be parts on it, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Because these are some of the next pieces I have to put on. So I'll show you where they go and what I meant by you'll never see some of this stuff. So, there you go. So a better part of all of the work that's under here and underneath this piece you won't ever see. But I'm going ahead and doing it anyway. Paint mixer, really nice addition to the kit. Now I'm going back and adding the metallic purple to all the stuff I just got through painting. free to ask questions in chat. Throw out their stuff that you want to know. Do my best to answer. could go in stream when nobody talks, huh? I'm not being so careful with this because I'm not too worried about if I get it on the red, as long as it's not too thick. Because it just blends in with the red metallic because it's already metallic flake. Probably the next time I do something like this, I have a, Citadel has a new paint system that they just introduced called contrast paints. And I've seen how they work, and they're a really good paint system, so probably what I'll go with. That's cut. Everything purple metallic coated. So I'm probably done painting for the moment, unless I want to paint some of this other stuff that's got to go on next. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put him on his base. Actually, before I do that, I want to get my Raidma toolkit. Some work on the base or on the mount. It's a little tight, so I'm going to try to loosen it up a little bit. This is usual stuff you want to do before you start painting and putting it together. This is how you mess up paint jobs. And I apologize for all the noise. That's got to be done. Beveling the top of the mound itself, so maybe it'll bury any of these here. There we go. Much better. I think what we're going to do is we're going to shift gears and we're going to start working on the next pieces that have to go on, since they need to be based. And what we're going to do is just get all this painted up. Paint mixer's been one of the best things I've bought since I've been doing this. It's a little noisy, but gets the job done. So we're going to switch to a different brush. That's going to be basing. And this color is a color that I mixed up myself. Alright, give me just a second to take this call from it because it is from work. Hello? Okay. 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 This is yeah. So is it Eli Construction? Eli. Okay, yeah, they usually hit a pretty good bid. I know Eli pretty good. So, 12-back might be better, and, yeah. Alright, yeah, I don't think that picked up. Okay. No. Okay. Yeah. All right, no problem. Bye. Well, I'll stream a little bit more, but yes, that's the inevitable call that I was waiting for. So, yeah, I gotta go into work for a little bit, so I'm gonna work on finishing this, but I've got a catering run I have to do before 5 o'clock. We have a flight going out and they need some alcohol specific for that flight. For those of you watching the stream who aren't aware, I work as a detailer for a private air charter company. And one of my duties is I have to go get catering if we have catering for specific flights, like specific food or drink that some of the clients want. I have to go pick it up. That'll pretty much be my day because I don't plan on doing a whole lot more today. As far as that work. Have a thing going on at work right now, and basically I work as minimal hours as I can to try and help the company out a little bit. Unfortunately, I'm 30 minutes away from work, so it's nothing for me just to jump in the truck, run, grab the credit card, go get what we need, and then drop it off and come back home. So. Yeah, this gray base gives this gold crimson that I mixed up a little bit of a different look. When you compare it to the black base that I'm running on the main body, because I'd already started painting the main body and I wasn't going to go back and rebase it. Kind of like how this lets a little bit more of that crimson come through, because the black base sort of brings out the gold in this, but this kind of lets the red metallic come through. But basically the contrast paints that I was mentioning before, the way they work is you use a metallic base. It's got to be a gloss metallic. So you use a gloss metallic base coat. And you do a watered down wash of your layer or your base paint. So you have paints that are base, layers, textures, so on and so forth. So you take your base, and as you wash it, basically it would go on like water, but when it dries, it actually pools in areas that are detailed. So like all these little holes and these little spots and all this little stuff, high spots, low spots, it basically flows into differently. And as the base dries, it darkens in the areas like the recesses and the little holes, and it's real light on open flat areas. So it looks really amazing, and it's a real good start. And then you can lightly wash other places. And then depending on how dark you want it, you can come straight out of the pot with it like I'm doing now. Or you can put it on a pallet, water it down, and then just let it flow into where you want it. What I'm using right now is a mix of a red metallic and a gold tester's enamel. And I watered it down just a little bit with some thinner to make it kind of flow a little bit. These are little tricks that you pick up from watching the other guys paint. And that's what I've been doing, is just kind of hanging out the last couple weekends, watching my boss and his friends paint, and picking up little tricks and techniques. And here in about two weeks, I think it's on the 15th, my boss is invited me up to ATC in Chattanooga, I think it is. And it's a big apocalypse level Warhammer tournament. We were going to play, but I don't think we're actually planning to now. We were going to put some armies on the table and have a game. But I think we're just going to go up and check things out and walk around and watch games and have fun. We're also planning on starting a YouTube channel. We haven't got it started yet, but we're going to start a YouTube channel where we're going to be doing battle reports. And basically what our boss is planning on doing, is he's going to go through the books, the lore books and any of the Warhammer stuff. And he's going to find the battles, the various battles that took part in the books. And what we're going to do is we're going to actually set up armies on a table, and we're going to play out the battles within those lore books. So that you can actually see these specific battles that happen, like the Battle for Hell's Reach, or you know, things of that nature. Basically, I just want to finish priming these few pieces, and then I'll head out and go get everything done. I don't think we got any flights coming back anytime soon, and I don't feel like sitting there wasting time trying to wait on them. The majority of my job is hurry up and wait. My boss will be at work when I get there. Might take my little bit of a model I've got done in and let him check it out firsthand. See, I showed him a picture of it the other day of just getting started, and he's really impressed with it, so I'd love to take it in and let him check it out. I'm gonna switch brushes since I'm doing a lot more detail work or a lot more open area on this. Like painting the oldies. This brush is putting on way too much paint. Trying not to leave brush strokes, so I'm trying to use as much coverage in a few strokes as possible. Switch to this real quick, get this fine detail. Hard sell to paint something we can't really hold on to. Don't really have a safe spot to grab this piece. I'd love to have a airbrush for doing this sort of stuff. With an airbrush, I could just, you know, sit back at a distance and just throw some color on this thing without having to really touch it. Risk getting fingerprints on it like that. Hold it by claws. I'll go ahead and paint this front piece right here. Even out some of those fingerprints real quick. Actually, I wonder if you have many tools. Don't let me do it. It's just too slick to grab it like right there, so keep dropping it, which is gonna mess up my finish. I think what I'm going to do is just hold it by this one spike. A real quick wash over everything. And I'm going to base it with purple anyway before I put this silver metallic purple over. So if I get a little bit of red inside of the lower area, then that's fine. And I don't necessarily have to paint this spike that I've got my finger on, because you can always hit it once I get everything glued on. Let those pieces sit cleaned up, and I'm gonna go get this catering run done, and Yeah, I do think I like how that red, that crimson looks on that gray base a lot better. That's looking kind of hot. But, alright, I have to run. So, I'm gonna end the stream. Fuzzy, thanks for coming back. I should be streaming later on. I don't know if I'm gonna be doing more with this. I may or may not. I may just finish these pieces and then be done for today and then do some game streaming. So if you want a guild invite, let me know. I'll be on later to play some WoW. So if you want a guild invite, just let me know. Catch you guys later.